confirmation, and the my counselor, advisor, whatever you call them, keeps saying, "Well, I'll get back to you," and she doesn't. So I presume it is, but I've already gotten an email to order my cap and gown, so I presume it's close.
Don't presume anything.
Bottom hand, fall away. stretching out. Bringing both hands to heart center. I'll come that breath in and out. Taking our arms up overhead and leaning to the left side. Letting that bottom hand fall away and stretching out. Bringing both hands back to heart center. A breath in and out. We'll take that left hand to our right knee. Right hand travels around behind, overlooking the right shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you. Coming back to center. That breath in and out. Right hand, left knee, left hand travels around behind, overlooking the left shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you. Turning to center. Another breath. We'll take our legs wide, stretching out. Right hand to the right ankle, and stretching that left arm over top. Bringing that left hand down to our right toes. Right hand to our right toes. And exhaling down. Nose to our right knee. Inhaling up, left hand, left ankle, and stretching the right arm over top. Bringing that right hand down to our left toes. Left hand to our left toes, and exhaling down. Nose to our left knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, and exhaling down, nose to our right knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down to our left knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers again, right toes, and exhaling down. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down. Inhaling up, we're bringing both legs together, coming forward for our forward fold. Inhaling up, bending the right knee, putting that right ankle on top of the left thigh, and stretching forward for those left toes. Taking both legs long, forward fold. Inhaling up, bending the left knee, putting that left ankle on top of the right thigh, and stretching forward for our right toes. And taking both legs long again, forward fold. Put the soles of our feet together in our butterfly position, letting our knees and our thighs drop out to the side. And we're just going to walk our hands forward, deepening our stretch. bringing our hands to heart center. We're slowly going to roll back, one vertebrae at a time. Keeping that butterfly position with our legs. And we'll bring our palms down on either side of our hips, pushing the soles of our feet together, down with our hands, bringing our backsides off the mat, and holding. Resting our backsides down, letting our knees and our thighs drop out to the side, bringing those hands to heart center, and slowly rolling up. Coming back into our seated position, and again we're going to stretch those arms out in front, dropping our fingertips to the mat, and walking our hands forward to deepen our stretch. And then again, we're bringing those hands to heart center. One more time, we're rolling back. Bringing those palms down on either side of our hips, pushing the soles of our feet together, down with our hands, bringing our backsides off the mat, and holding. Resting our backsides down, letting our knees and thighs drop out to the side. Bringing our hands to heart center, and again we're rolling back up into our seated position. Stretching those arms out front. Separating our palms, letting them drift down to the mat. And walking those fingers forward, deepening our stretch. And again, bringing our hands to heart center, leaving our legs in that butterfly position. We're going to turn our torso off to the right. Coming back to center and turning our torso to the left. Coming back to center and then coming forward into our tabletop position. Hands and knees. Starting in our cow with our head up and relaxing our back. Here's cat, inhaling, tucking my head. Arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling back around into our cow. Our cat again, inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up. And holding. And exhaling back around into cow. And one more cat, inhaling, tugging my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. And exhaling back around into our cow. We'll cross that right knee in front of the left. Right palm is down, rotating. Left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, rotating. Right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down. Here's our threading the needle. Right arm underneath the left. Right shoulders headed down to the mat. And we'll take that left arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating the left shoulder
taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. And I'm placing my palms down, straightening my arms. I'll bring this left arm underneath the right. Left shoulder's headed down to the mat. And we'll take that right arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating your right shoulder, taking your arm and your fingers on up towards the ceiling, placing our palms down, straightening our arms, exhaling down onto our forearms, and exhaling one more time, dropping my forehead onto the mat, and stretching those arms out long in front of me. We'll leave our legs in the position they're in, but we're slowly going to roll up and take those arms overhead. And we're exhaling back down, sliding our arms out in front and putting our forehead on the mat. Again, leaving our legs in the position they're in, we're slowly going to roll up, take those arms overhead. And exhaling down, putting our forehead on the mat and stretching those arms out long in front of us. And then unwinding, coming back into our table. A breath in and out. This time it'll be, let's see, was it the right knee in front of the left that we did last time? I don't remember.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So left in front of the right. Left palm is down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, we'll take the left arm underneath the right. Left shoulder's headed down to the mat. And we'll take that right arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating the right shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers up overhead. Placing our palms down. Straightening our arms, then we'll take the right arm underneath the left, right shoulders headed down to the mat, and we're taking that left arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating the left shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. Placing my palms down, straightening my arms, exhaling down onto my forearms, and if you choose, exhaling one more time, dropping our forehead onto the mat, and stretching those arms out long in front of us. And then we'll leave our legs in the position they're in. We're slowly going to roll up. Take those arms overhead. Exhaling down, sliding our arms down in front and putting our forehead back on the mat. And then again, one more time, leaving our legs in the position you're in. We're slowly going to roll up. Take those arms overhead. Exhaling our hands down, sliding our arms out in front, and putting our forehead on the mat. And returning back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll turn to the right side, looking back at that right foot. Coming to center, turning to the left side, looking back at that left foot, and coming back to center. We'll stretch that arm out front and take that left leg out behind us. Bending my left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting left knee, stretching out right arm, left leg, bending that left knee, drawing that right elbow back, connecting left knee, and stretching out. This time as you bend that left knee, we'll take that right hand around, see if we can hang on to those left toes. And coming back into our table. Our breath in and out. We'll take that left arm out in front and bring that right leg out behind us. Bending my right knee, drawing that left elbow back, connecting right knee, stretching out, bending my right knee, drawing that left elbow back, connecting right knee, and stretching out. This time as you bend the right knee, we'll bring that left hand around and see if we can hang on to those right toes. And returning to our table position, a breath in and out. We'll take this right arm out to the side and see if the left leg will join it out to the side. Leaving the right arm out to the side, we'll take that left leg behind us. Bringing that left leg out to the side. Taking that left leg behind us. And once more, taking that left leg out to the side. And returning back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll take that left arm out to the side and see if the right leg might join it. And then we'll take that right leg around behind us. Taking that right leg out to the side. Bringing that right leg behind us. And one last time, taking that right leg out to the side. And returning back into our table. Our breath in and out. When you're ready, we're going to tuck our toes, coming up into down dog. And we'll start by walking the dog. Right knee forward and back, left knee forward and back, just like we're walking. Settling back into our down dog. Bringing that right hand over to the left ankle. Coming back. Down dog. Left hand over to the right ankle. And coming back. Down dog. We'll bring that right foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up, bringing your arms overhead. Warrior one. Connecting right hand back by our hip, pushing the left arm forward. Bringing both arms forward. And back up. Warrior one. And we're going to bring those hands to heart center. Move that left foot out to the side, and we'll take it into a curtsy and hold. And then stepping back into our warrior one. Bringing those hands down on either side of the right foot. And scooting that right foot back into our down dog. Now we'll bring that left foot forward in between both hands in front. And when you're ready, inhaling up for your warrior one. Connecting my palms together, extending forward over the left thigh. Bringing that left hand back by my hip, pushing the right arm forward. Bringing both arms forward. And back up. Warrior one. Here we'll bring our hands to heart center, and we're going to head into that curtsy. So I'm going to take that right foot behind the left, bend to my knees, coming into our curtsy pose and holding. And then stepping back into our warrior one. Bringing both hands down on either side of the left foot. And we're bringing that left foot back into our down dog. We'll bring our big toes together, side by side and back. We're going to bend our knees, come forward on our toes, and hold. From this position, we're just going to widen our stance, so we're going to bring our feet to the outside of the mat. Again, bending our knees, coming up onto our toes, and holding. And bringing your feet back into that original position, toes side by side, bending your knees, coming up onto your toes and holding. And finally, stepping back into your down dog. Putting our weight on that right foot, we'll take that left leg out behind us for three-legged dog. Bending my left knee, turning my hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. If you need it to be harder, walking your hands back and see if you can put them around the right ankle. And returning back into our down dog. Putting our weight on that left foot as we take that right leg out behind us. Bending my right knee, turning my hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. And if you need it to be harder, walking your hands back and see if you could put them around that left ankle. And stepping back, down dog. Walking our feet forward, right behind our hands. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up. And settling into that mountain position.
I'll take the right hand down the outside of the right thigh, stretching the left over top. Bringing that left hand down the outside of the left thigh, stretching the right over top. And coming back into our mountain. Let's do our warrior two. Right foot is forward, left is behind. We're bending the right knee. Arms are out, overlooking those right fingertips. Taking the right arm up. Coming back, warrior two. We'll take the right hand all the way down, the left is up. Coming back, warrior two. And then we'll bring that lower left forearm connected to the outside of the right lower leg and take that right arm up towards the ceiling. And unwinding, coming back, warrior two. And stepping back into our mountain. A breath in and out. Warrior two, other side, left foot is forward, right is behind. We're bending that left knee, arms are out, overlooking the left fingertips. Taking the left hand up. Coming back, warrior two. And we'll take that left hand all the way down. The right is up. Coming back, warrior two. And then we'll bring that lower right forearm forward, connected to the outside of the left lower leg, and take that left arm up towards the ceiling. Unwinding, coming back, warrior two. And stepping back into our mountain. A breath in and out. Getting ready, here's our sun salutation. Arms overhead. Coming forward into our forward fold. Hands behind our calves. Relaxing my head, relaxing my neck. Putting my hands on the mat in front of my toes. Bringing those hands up to our knees, down to the mat, up to our knees, down to the mat, and once more, up to our knees, and back down to the mat. Leaving the right foot forward, we'll take the left behind into our lunge. Right palm is down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down. Here we'll take it into our triangle. So we're going to straighten the right knee, put the right hand on the right ankle, rotate to the left, and take that left arm up. And then we're coming back into our lunge, hands on the mat, bending the right knee. We'll bring the right forearm up on top of the right thigh, stretching the left arm overhead. For our side angle. Only thing we'll change is position of our arms, left forearm on that right thigh, and taking the right arm overhead. And then we'll take that into our reverse warrior. Right
hands together, heart center. Connecting my thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands to heart center. Inner twist, left elbow, right knee, turning to the side. And we're putting both hands down by that right foot. Getting ready, scooting that right foot back into our down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. Putting the left foot down, tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting the right foot down. And then we're going to walk our hands back towards our feet into a forward fold. Here we're going to bend our knees, pretend we're sitting in a chair, and take our arms out front for chair pose. We'll bring those hands to heart center, and we're going to take it into our goddess by coming into a squat. Turning that into our garland by taking our arms up overhead. Bringing our hands back to heart center. We'll stretch those arms back out front, and we're going to come back into our chair. And coming forward into our down dog. We're going to walk our feet back into our plank position. Here's our hip dip right hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank. Hip dip left hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank. And we often walk the dog, but we don't usually walk the plank. So today we'll walk the plank, bringing that right knee forward and back. And that left knee forward and back. Walking the plank. Settling back into our plank. And coming all the way down. Your choice, either resting on your forearms for Sphinx, or palms down, and pushing your chest up for Cobra. When you're ready, tucking your toes, we're going to head back into our down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and fold, holding. Putting the left foot down. Tucking my chin, bringing that right knee forward and holding. Putting our right foot down, and then we're walking our hands back into that forward fold. And then one last round, we're going to bend our knees and take our arms out front for our chair. Bring those hands to heart center, coming into our squat, our goddess position. Taking that into our garland, arms overhead. Bringing those hands to heart center. We'll take those arms out front and we're headed back into our chair. And then we're coming back into our down dog. We'll bring that left foot forward, the right is behind.
Left palm is down, rotating.
Right arm and fingers overhead.
Bringing that right hand down, rotating.
Left arm and fingers overhead.
Bringing that left hand down. We're going to turn that into our triangle very briefly, bringing that left hand to our left ankle, straightening that left knee,
rolling outward to the right, and taking the right arm overhead, giving us triangle.
And coming back into our lunge. Here's our side angle,
left forearm on top of the left thigh, and taking that right arm overhead. Only thing we'll change is position of our arms, right forearm on that left thigh, and taking that left arm overhead. Taking that into a reverse warrior, left hand says hello to the sun.
Bringing both hands together, heart sun. Connecting my thumbs between my eyebrows, looking up. Bringing those hands to heart center. And our twist, right elbow, left knee, turning to the side.
And we'll put both hands down by that left foot.
Getting ready, bringing that right foot forward into our forward fold. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up. Settling into our mountain position. A breath in and out. We'll come forward into our table, and then here we're headed over onto our backs. Feet down, knees up, arms wide. That breath in and out. We'll cross that right leg over the left, and we'll take both knees off to the left side. Taking that into our shrimp pose, extending that top leg nice and long. We're reaching around with the right hand for the toes or the ankle on the bottom. And bringing that left arm up towards the ceiling. And then unwinding, feet down, knees up, arms wide. That breath in and out. We'll cross the left leg over the right, and we're going to take both knees off to the right side for our side twist. If you want to do shrimp pose, taking that top leg, extending it long, with the left hand reaching around for the toes or the ankle on the bottom. And then maybe taking that right arm up towards the ceiling. And unwinding, feet down, knees up. A breath in and out. We'll take that right leg up towards the ceiling. Roll that right ankle, first one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me, pushing them away, towards me, and away. And then starting that circle with my right leg. Making that circle go around the other way. Taking my right leg all the way up towards the ceiling. And as I exhale, lowering that right heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor and holding. As I exhale the next time, dropping that right heel almost to the mat, not quite there.
letting it hover. And I'm taking the right leg all the way back up, and with both hands, I'm going to reach for those right toes. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up. We'll take that left leg up towards the ceiling. And roll that left ankle, first one way, and then the other. Pulling my toes towards me, pushing them away, towards me, and away, and then starting that circle with my left leg. Maybe making my circle go around the other way. Taking that left leg up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, lowering that left heel halfway between the ceiling and the floor and holding. As you exhale the next time, dropping that left heel almost to the mat, not quite there, letting it hover. And I'm taking the left leg all the way up with both hands then, reaching for those left toes. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up, a breath in, and out. We'll take both legs up towards the ceiling, and we're going to make a motion like we're bicycling. So you can go fast or you can go slow. Whatever you want to do. And you can either keep bicycling, or you can interlace your fingers, put them behind your head, and it will be opposite elbow to opposite knee as those knees come forward. Do reclining eagle, crossing that right leg over the left, bending my arms at the elbows, right forearm over the left, connecting my fingers, and then I'm going to pick up that foot that's on the mat and bring my knees towards my elbows and hold. And then releasing out, feet down, knees up. Reclining eagle, other side. So we're going to cross that left leg over the right. Bending my arms at the elbows. Left forearm over the right. Connecting my fingers. And I'm going to pick up that foot on the mat, bringing my knees as close to my elbows as I can, and holding. And releasing out, feet down, knees up, and then we'll roll over and take a moment in child's pose. And then making ourselves comfortable for our shavasana. Inhalation for about inhalation and your exhalation. Slowly bringing your awareness to your forehead, smoothing out your forehead. Relaxing your eyebrows, relaxing that place between your eyebrows. Drawing the relaxation down through your cheeks and into your jaw. Maybe opening your mouth just a little bit as you invite your jaw to relax. Drawing that relaxation down through your neck. And as you exhale, dropping your shoulders, releasing them. Thinking about deepening that space between the bottom of your ears and the tops of your shoulders. Drawing the relaxation down through your arms, into your wrists, softening your hands, releasing your fingers, allowing your thoughts to just come and go, not dwelling on any one thing. Bring that relaxation down through your chest, into your tummy, relaxing your hips, softening your thighs, releasing your knees, lower legs, ankles, and your feet. And taking a moment to continue to drift and melt. Journey, you find yourself in a mountain cabin, and you're in a bathing suit, you have your sandals on, and a warm bathrobe wrapped around you, and you're ready to head out the cabin door to those hot springs that are in the backyard. Opening the cabin door and stepping out, you'll notice there's a light dusting of snow on the trail to the hot springs. And once in a while, as you travel on the path, some of that snow brushes across your toes in your sandals. And you notice the cool, tingly feeling of the snow. As you approach the hot springs, you can see the steam rising up from the surface of the water. You notice all the snow has melted around the area just outside the springs. Making your way closer, you notice the air is warmer here, and you decide
to take off your bathrobe, setting it down on one of those warm rocks. Making your way into the hot springs. The water is shallow here. It's right around your ankles. Taking a moment to accustom yourself to the warmth of the water after the snowy path. As you look around the hot spring pool, you notice a ledge made out of a rock on one of the sides of the hot springs. You wade your way over to that and sit down in the water. Again, allowing your body to become accustomed to the warmth. Allowing yourself to relax. As you look out beyond the hot springs, you notice some mountain peaks that have a dusting of white snow on their summit. You notice the tall firs, cedars, and pines dotting the hillside. Taking a moment in this beautiful place to see what's meant for you to see on your journey today. Coming back to your breath. Noticing its peaceful, easy rhythm. Taking a moment to give thanks for whatever comes to mind today. Also taking a moment to think about our intentions. All those good things we'd like to do. Gathering those positive affirmations in our mind. And when we have those intentions gathered together, either in our mind's eye, or we can raise our arms up over our head and send all those good thoughts outward. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. Making our way over to the side of the hot springs where our bathrobe has been warmed on those warm rocks, putting the warm, comfortable bathrobe around us, and setting back off towards the cabin on that trail. You'll notice on the way back you're not bothered by stepping into the snow. You don't notice the coolness of the snow on your toes as you make your way back into the cabin. Opening the door, stepping inside. Taking a deep breath in. Exhaling out. Reconnecting with our bodies. Noticing the rise and fall of our chest. As we inhale and as we exhale. Checking in with our fingers, wiggling our fingers, seeing how they feel. Checking in with our toes, wiggling our toes, noticing how they feel. Allowing our senses to bring us back to the room around us.
taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. And when you're ready to come back from your journey, only when you're ready to come back, gently sitting up and taking your time.